I'm Madina from Afghanistan. I ask a question, why we do live in Afghanistan in war while teenagers live in America or other countries in peace? Why I should live in war?
I'm the BBC's correspondent based in Afghanistan. I've been reporting on this war for the past 5 years. To answer this question, we have to go where the war is taking place right now. I'm traveling to a school in the middle of the conflict.
This could be Afghanistan's most dangerous school. Wedged between Taliban and government fighters, there is no escaping the war. Over the last 20 years, around 50 students and 12 teachers have been killed or injured in this area. All the students I speak to have direct experience of the war.
There is a tank parked behind our school. When it fires into the valley below, on several occasions, glass has fallen on pupils, to the point where blood is flowing. The boys then have to leave school and lessons. It makes you forget what you have learned in the past few hours. All your thoughts get messed up. You wonder if the shell hit your house, because everyone has family.
Children of both Taliban and government forces study together.
I come from the Taliban side of the front line. It's very difficult coming here for school. There have been occasions where I have been caught in crossfire. Planes drop bombs and a tank in the nearby base shells our area. Smaller guns and bullets can also be heard. We come to study under these circumstances. It's a source of pride for us.
This war is a lot older than you are. What have you heard? What do you think? How did it all begin?
This war began 26 years before I was born. But from the story that my father, elders, and brothers have told me, the war first started after other countries invaded Afghanistan.
In 1979, the Soviet Union invaded Afghanistan to support its pro-Soviet government. After 10 years of fighting, Soviet troops withdrew, but a civil war began. Amongst this chaos, the Taliban sprang up, a group who followed a radical form of Islam, enforced punishments like public executions, and forced girls out of education. The Taliban first took control of the capital, Kabul, in 1996 and ruled most of the country within 2 years. They allowed an Islamic militant group called Al-Qaeda to have training camps in Afghanistan. On September the 11th, 2001, attacks in the USA killed nearly 3,000 people. The head of Al-Qaeda, Osama bin Laden, was blamed for the attacks. US-led troops invaded Afghanistan after the Taliban refused to hand bin Laden over. Though the Taliban were removed from power that November, the militant group remained a fighting force. After the longest war in US history, a significant number of international forces pulled back in 2014. But the war continues, with the Afghan government and Taliban fighting to this day. The Taliban say they will fight until the complete withdrawal of all foreign troops. Only boys study here. There are girls' schools in the area further back from the fighting. But many girls are still deprived of an education because of security and cultural factors.
Now there is war, of course, but we should work for our future generation. We make progress if we think positively, to study no matter what, and never give up.
It is the dream of every Afghan to see peace. There is one word in the mouth of every Afghan: peace, peace. The word may rot in people's mouths, but peace may never come.